Hey, what is up guys, my name is Kosmin and today I have a new video tutorial for you. Now I'll be doing an icon design inside Illustrator CC. That's the only thing I'll be using. This is the email I got a couple of days ago. It says, "Hey Kosmin, I'd like to have an icon for our new app that allows people to share the location with their friends, whether it's at a concert or a date. Meetmee gives the user the ability to connect easier. We only need an icon." That's what they'll be using. Their only request is to have some vibrant colors, so that's pretty easy to do. So what I did, I went inside to color.adobe.com and I played around with a couple of color schemes. Then I simply added a rectangle inside the new Illustrator document and copied the hex code and just added those colors inside the swatches panel. Just to have them available. Now to start this off, I'll go to view and show grid and then make sure that every element snaps to that grid. I have an idea of making, since it's a location sharing app, I want to have something that's related. So the first thing that came into mind was a location pin. So that's what I'll be doing now. With the direct selection tool, I just took the bottom anchor and dragged it on a bit and then adjusted those handles on the side to make it look like a location pin. Now I use the grid to make sure that I have a symmetrical placement of those handles on both sides. And once I did that, I want to have, since the app name is Meetmee, I wanted to have an M somehow. You'll see later, but right now I want to add a couple of elements on the left hand side, and then using the reflect tool, which is O, I'm just hitting O on my keyboard to add it. So hit O, click where you want to reflect that element, and then simply hold down the Alt key to duplicate it in place. And afterwards I want to have a round shape at the top, just to give it more to look more like an M. Now this is an abstract interpretation of a location pin, just because usually a location pin icon has a small circle somewhere in the middle, but I'll use this as the base. Now my idea is to create an icon that has a gradient that's made out of multiple elements with the same gradient, just to give it more depth and make it look more interesting, I guess. So what I do, I simply select the main element, the pin, and using the R key, I rotated it to 45 degrees and duplicated it. And now I did the same thing with those two and just adjusted the angle a couple of degrees further. And the whole point is to have four different elements that's going to be clipped on the initial design. So what I do, using the Pathfinder tool, I just merged those two elements, and now I'm going to group those four and just placing it on top of it. Just use command 7 and that will create a clipping mask. Now I'm not sure what's going on here because I still have a couple of elements left. Yeah, they were just duplicated in place. Let me just remove this real quick and place it back again. And once I select the layer on top, I just hit command 7 and I have a clipping mask active. Now I want to adjust those corners and make them more round. So with the direct selection tool, I just selected those two at the top and then the anchors at the bottom. And just by dragging from that small circle that shows up, you can create some round corners. Now I can start creating the gradient. So the first thing, I'm going to apply a very basic gradient and then add the colors and create a three colored gradient. And now I'll try it like this, but right now it's maybe it's too vibrant for what I would like to have. So let's add something darker. And now it's just a matter of starting to play around with the gradient tool, and that can be accessed by hitting the G keystroke, or you can find it in the toolbar. But I'll start adjusting every single gradient to make sure that I have a smooth transition between these multiple elements. The whole idea is to create a gradient using multiple gradients. I'm not sure if it makes sense now, but it will make sense very soon. I just want it to be very bright on the right hand side and go to darker on the left hand side, while still playing with the gradient on these four elements, and making sure the transition is similar. So it's not bright, dark, bright, dark. It just gets darker and darker with every single element. Now the gradient tool is pretty easy to use. You just click and drag, and then you can make adjustments like the rotation of it. Right now I can see I feel like this already looks good, but again, it's all a matter of trying new things. So let me just duplicate this real quick. I've selected everything by clicking down and selecting everything, and holding down the Alt key, you can make a duplicate. So let's place this on a dark background, and that's how I want to use it in the final presentation. But placing it on a different color gives you a better look on what works and what doesn't. For example, I noticed that in the left hand corner you could see the other path, the second element, so I wanted to mask that off. And now that I have this, I'll want to have something brighter for this element on the right. So again, I'm just using the gradient tool and just going through a couple of revisions until I get something I like. And now I'll do the same with the one on the left, but first I want to check out and see what's going on here, because I saw there are a couple of stranded anchors, so I wanted to remove those just because it was bugging me. Now let's place this back and play again with the gradients and do small adjustments. Now I'll ungroup everything and start trying to adjust every single element that's left. As you can see, it's just a matter of trying out ideas. I have a general idea of how I want it to look, but that doesn't mean that I'll achieve it unless I try multiple times. As you can see right here, the gradient is not placed correctly, so I had to rotate it a bit, and now it blends in more with the element right next to it. So I can do just small adjustments that gives this cool opacity look. It feels like you've played with overlaying styles and overlaying modes to get this, but actually it's just the same gradient with different orientations. For the left hand side, I wanted to mimic a drop shadow, so that's what I did there. Again, just the same gradient, but having three colors to work with helps so much. In the end, this is the design I like. I'll just create a full stretch background. For some reason the mouse is acting up weird. It's just behind. It just looks like it's behind what it's actually been doing. So let me just add a rectangle behind it. I'll make sure the corners are rounded. Again, just with the direct selection tool, you click and drag on those points. And I'll place the same gradient on the on the actual app icon, but have a very subtle hint of that violet. Most of the background will be using this dark color. So to make it stand out more, I even added a drop shadow from the effects panel. Stylize, you can find it as a drop shadow. Play around with the opacity a bit and just hit OK. And this is the final design. Let me know if you liked it. Let me know if you have any questions. As always, I'd be more than happy to help. And till next time, see ya.